So hello students, this is Brijendra Dwivedi here with the class 11th chemistry, and the first chapter that I am going to take is general organic chemistry. So this general organic chemistry is the chapter which I am going to discuss. In this chapter we will learn something very basic which is related with organic chemistry, how it evolved, how it is named. So in 17th century, when chemistry was in its growing stage, all the known compounds of that time were classified into two categories, and this classification was done on the basis of source from which they have been obtained. If the compound was obtained from any living source, means either it was obtained from a plant or it was obtained from an animal, then it was classified as organic. And when the compound was classified, when the compound was obtained from any non-living source, then it was classified as inorganic. So compounds are classified into two categories as inorganic and organic, and this classification was done on the basis of source from which these compounds are obtained. Inorganic are those that were obtained from non-living things. Example, rock salt, nitre, these are the compounds that were obtained from the non-living things. But carbohydrates, proteins, enzymes, hormones, these are the compounds that were directly or indirectly obtained from living sources, either from plants or from animals. So this classification is done on the basis of source from which they have been obtained. Actually, the verbal meaning of term organic is related with life. So all those compounds, all those substances that were obtained from the living things are classified as organic, and all those which are obtained from non-living things, they were classified as inorganic. So that is how these two terms, organic and inorganic, has came in existence. Then later on it has been found that all those compounds that has been classified as organic, in structure of all those compounds, carbon was present as one of the essential elements in their structures. All those compounds that were classified as organic compounds, they were basically the compounds of carbon. So that is how this branch organic chemistry has been arisen. So basically the meaning of term organic is related with life. And all these compounds which has been classified as organic, they were only separated from animals. Say for example, cane sugar, it was obtained from the sacrum, cane sugar, and urea that was separated from the urine, etc. So there was a group of scientists which believed that these compounds which we have classified as organic cannot be synthesized in the laboratory. And this concept was given by J.J. Berzelius and is called as vital force theory. This vital force theory was given by this scientist J.J. Berzelius, according to which organic compounds can only be synthesized inside the living systems under the influence of a mysterious force called as vital force. As we know that in every living creature, whether it is an animal or it is a plant, there is something that makes them living. There are certain signs of a living organism. They undergo nutrition, there is locomotion, there is excretion, there is reproduction. Living systems are recognized by these factors. Whether it is a plant or animal, both the sort of living things undergo these life processes. There is respiration, there is nutrition, there is excretion, there is reproduction. And there is something mysterious among all these living things that makes them living actually. And that mysterious force is termed as vital force. And Berzelius believed that organic compounds cannot be synthesized outside the living systems. They cannot be synthesized in the laboratory. They can only be synthesized inside the living systems under the presence of this mysterious force, what we call as vital force. However, it was his own student Friedrich Wöhler who was able to synthesize an organic compound from completely inorganic sources. He heated ammonium cyanate, NH4CNO, and on heating it rearranged into urea. Before this synthesis, this urea was obtained from the urine of mammals. These cows, buffalo, horse, humans, they all comes under this category, mammals, and urine of mammals has got urea. So since this urea was earlier obtained from this living thing, so it was classified as an organic compound. But this organic compound was synthesized by heating ammonium cyanate, which in turn was obtained by heating potassium cyanate and ammonium chloride, which was entirely inorganic nature. That is, they were being obtained from the non-living things. So this urea was the first organic compound to be synthesized outside the living system. First organic compound synthesized, urea. So this was the first blow to this vital force theory. Then afterwards, Kolbe was able to synthesize acetic acid, Berthold was able to synthesize methane, and in coming 20-30 years, many of the compounds which was being classified as organic was synthesized in the lab. And as on date, there is no organic compound which we cannot synthesize in the lab. No vital force is required for their synthesis. And that is how, with the passage of time, the term organic has lost its original significance, but the term is still in use, and the branch of chemistry that deals with the study of these compounds is called organic chemistry. So this was a historical discussion actually, how the term organic has came in origin. Organic means related with life, and all those compounds that were obtained either directly or indirectly from these living things, from the living creatures, from plants, from animals, are classified as organic compounds. Although in initial time we believed that organic compounds cannot be synthesized in the laboratory, they can only be synthesized inside the living system under the influence of a mysterious force which is called as vital force. But as on date, that concept is being proved wrong, and we can synthesize these compounds in the laboratory also. So what is the current definition of organic chemistry? In modern era, we say that the branch of chemistry that deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. It is called organic chemistry. Here the literal meaning of organic is not considered. In the modern view, we say that organic chemistry is that branch of chemistry that deals with the study of hydrocarbons and derivatives. So what are hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbons are the simplest organic compounds known. They have contains only two elements in their structure. One is hydrogen, from where that hydro word is taken, and carbon. They are only made up of these two elements, carbon and hydrogen. And if one or more hydrogens of a hydrocarbon is replaced by any other atom or by any other group, then the resulting compounds are called as derivatives of hydrocarbon. Let me clarify this point with one example. So this CH4 is the simplest hydrocarbon named as methane. This we know from our previous knowledge. Since this contains only carbon and hydrogen, so it is a hydrocarbon. Now, for example, if one of these hydrogens are replaced with a chlorine atom, then here we have CH3Cl. If one of its hydrogens are replaced with a COOH group, so we have CH3COOH. If one of the hydrogens are replaced with a CHO group, so we have CH3CO. If one hydrogen is replaced with a OH group, so we have CH3OH, and so on so forth. If three hydrogens are replaced by three Cl groups, so we have CHCl3. I have taken these common examples because these are some of the very common chemicals that we know in our daily life. This compound CHCl3 is chloroform, which is used as an anesthetic. This CH3OH is methyl alcohol or wood alcohol, methanol. This is acetaldehyde. This is acetic acid or ethanoic acid, which is present in the vinegar. We all have enjoyed the Chinese food with this compound. And this is methyl chloride. So all these compounds, methyl chloride, acetic acid, acetaldehyde, methanol, chloroform, they have been formed by replacement of one or more hydrogens from this hydrocarbon. So all these are called as derivatives. They are derived from a hydrocarbon. So they are called derivatives of hydrocarbon. So as per the modern view, organic chemistry is that branch of chemistry which deals with the study of hydrocarbons and their derivatives. In fact, to understand this concept is very important. This will help you to learn many other concepts also. In this concept, it is presumed that all the organic compounds were basically hydrocarbons and they had came to their original, this current form by replacement of either one or more hydrogen atoms by any other atom or any other group. So this is the modern definition of organic chemistry. Then let us learn one more concept. What is allotropy and what are allotropes? Allotropes and allotropy. There are certain elements which exist in the nature in more than one physically different but chemically similar forms. And these different forms of the same element are called as its allotropes. In allotropes, physical properties are different but chemical properties are same, and both forms are same element. So if any element exists in more than one physically different forms but chemically similar forms, then these forms are called as allotropes and this phenomena is called as allotropy. This phenomena of allotropy is very important with carbon especially. Carbon exists in many physically different but chemically similar forms. For example, graphite, diamond, carbon black, all these three are the different forms of carbon. Their physical properties are different. For example, this is crystalline conductor, soft. This is crystalline insulator, very hard. This is amorphous, soft insulator. So their physical properties are quite different from each other. In fact, diamond is the hardest substance and it is an electrically insulator. Electricity doesn't conduct through diamond. But graphite is soft. It is so soft that it is used for making lubricants. It is electrical conductor, very good conductor. It is used for making electrodes in various processes. While carbon black is amorphous, soft, This is also insulator. So all these different forms, they are allotropes of carbon. Their physical properties are different, but their chemical properties are same. If any one of these forms are being burned in the oxygen, they all will give you carbon dioxide. This C reacts with oxygen to form CO2. This C you may take in the form of graphite, this C you may take in the form of diamond, or this C we may take in the form of carbon black. Is there anyone can tell me what are the other allotropic forms newly discovered? Yes, Buckminster fullerenes, graphene, carbon nanotubes, these are the newly discovered allotropes of carbon. So in this module, I had given you the historical overview that how the term organic was being originated, what is the meaning of term organic, what is vital force theory, how it was being discarded, and what is the modern definition of organic compounds and organic chemistry. Thank you.